नमस्कार एंड हेलो, वेलकम टू योर फेवरेट श्रीदेवी क्लासेज यूट्यूब चैनल, वेयर वी इनकल्केट इंटरेस्ट एंड कॉन्फिडेंस इन टेक्निकल सब्जेक्ट्स बाय क्लैरिटी ऑफ कंसेप्ट एंड राइट अंडरस्टैंडिंग। टुडे इन आवर प्लेलिस्ट इलेक्ट्रिक पावर सिस्टम वी विल स्टडी एडवांस प्रैक्टिस पार्ट ऑफ विंड टर्बाइन जनरेशन एंड इट इज थर्ड वीडियो इन अ सीरीज ऑफ डबल फेड इंडक्शन जनरेटर। लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड सम प्रैक्टिकल कंसेप्ट ऑफ विंड टर्बाइन जनरेशन। विंड इज अ site specific resource of energy. One cannot commission and operate wind turbine plants at any arbitrary positions. Installation and commissioning of wind power plant involve huge amount of investment, and operation of a wind power plant is very complex and it definitely need careful planning and perfect position selection. Good place for wind turbine operation should have annual average wind speed at least 5.8 meter per second. If one operate a large utility size wind turbine of 2 megawatt power or higher, favorable sites for wind farm includes top of smooth or rounded hills, open plains or onshore water positions, or some mountain gaps where funnel action can intensify wind velocities. These wind farms are cluster of several wind turbines and they together can produce large amount of electricity. In comparison to vertical axis wind turbine, these horizontal axis wind turbine have more difficult installation and maintenance procedures. But majority of utility wind turbines are horizontal axis wind turbines, and the key support for this selection is their higher power rating, very good efficiencies, lower cost, and important and significant, they are self-starting type. It is found that wind resources at higher elevation around 120 meter above earth surface are more favorable for electricity generation. So modern high power utility turbine of 2 megawatt or 3 megawatt are placed on tower of height either 120 meter or 140 meters. These taller turbines have longer turbine blades, and when they rotate they sweep larger area and thus generate more electricity. Neckel is the main power center of wind turbine generator. All energy conversion takes place within this Neckel part. Neckel sits on the top of tall wind turbine tower. Neckel sets with its bed on top of tall tower of turbine. To one side of Neckel on hub, turbine blades are connected, and these turbine blades collect wind energy and convert that into angular rotation motion of high torque and low RPM, 10 to 15 revolution per minute speed. A gearbox convert this low RPM high torque angular rotation into convenient 1000 RPM high speed rotation for generator shaft. In Neckel, along with modern double feed induction generator, its electronic controller, step up transformer, we have controller for yaw movement and blade pitch movement, and safety provision of emergency mechanical brakes. Blades of horizontal axis wind turbine are like airplane propeller. They have typical airfoil shape, and when wind velocity make a attack on turbine blade, the curvature and motion of blade produce relatively reduced wind velocity to one side, and lower airflow will increase pressure at bottom side of this blade, and curvature and motion of blade generate faster airflow at top, and that decrease pressure at top positions, and this pressure difference generated by this action produce a lift action and angular movement of turbine. Almost all horizontal axis wind turbine have three blade design. Three blade horizontal axis wind turbine is most energy efficient and balanced in design, and it generate less amount of noise during rotation. In fact, three blade design got higher stability as its dynamic properties during motion are similar to a balanced disc. But all horizontal axis wind turbine needs their orientation control when direction of wind changes to harness wind energy to optimum level. In turbine, yaw mechanism is provided on top of tower. Yaw mechanism is attached to knuckle bed, and this yaw mechanism is used to turn knuckle bed in such a way that turbine will get its orientation perpendicular to the direction of wind blow. So when your control automatically orient wind turbine position, it can take maximum advantage of kinetic energy of wind blow and produce maximum rotational mechanical energy from wind energy. For controlled force yawing of wind turbine, all horizontal axis wind turbine have vane and anemometer installed at the top of knuckle body. These vanes and anemometer observe wind velocity and direction, and data registered by anemometer are sent to controller inside a knuckle, and microprocessor based controller drive an electric motor that with suitable attached gearbox automatically control position of this knuckle bed such that turbine blades will come perpendicular to wind blow directions. The knuckle bed will turn around this crown, which is located at the top of wind turbine tower here. Though modern double fed induction generator can maintain grid connectivity of electrical output irrespective of variation in wind velocities or turbine rotation, but all turbines also have automatic blade pitching direction control. When an anemometer sense wind velocities and they send their information to electronic pitch controller that also check power output of turbine at various time conditions, and when it found electrical output too high, it sends an order to blade pitch mechanism to turn blade orientation so that turbine rotational speed remain within rated conditions, and vice versa. If turbine output is decreasing or wind velocities are decreasing, the automatic pitching control turn back these blades in such a way to increase mechanical output of turbine. So this pitching control mechanism using pitch control motor and gearbox maintain operation of wind turbine within rated RPM conditions for small variations in wind velocities. Wind turbine also possess aerodynamic safety provision against overspeed of turbine blade, which may arise when wind velocity all of a sudden increases to a very high values, or there exist a electric fault in grid system and electric output supply to grid has stopped to a great extent. And in all those overspeeding conditions, for the protection of this turbine system, aerodynamic spring operated braking system is provided, which can turn these rotor blades or tips by about 90 degree angle about this longitudinal axis, and that ensure minimum mechanical impact on wind turbine blades so as to obtain a very gentle, extremely safe and secure way to stop rotor from mechanical backup brakes available in rotating systems, and this avoid any sort of damage which may occur in our wind turbine systems by overspeeding operation. In all wind turbine systems, mechanical braking system is also provided as a backup safety provision in rotating systems. In turbine, rotor blade in hub rotate at a slow RPM, 10 to 15 revolution per minute, and this connected gearbox lift turning velocity of this high torque, low speed shaft of turbine to moderate torque and high speed 10,000 to 15,000 RPM as required for generator for 4-pole or 6-pole configuration. The turbine rotor shaft is connected to ring gear of planetary system, and 3 or 4 planetary gear convert this low RPM and high torque rotation to increase speed rotation in this middle sun gear. To handle tremendous high torque and to maintain mechanical stability, usually all turbine gear got initial planetary gear mechanism, and this sun gear wheel increase speed in two cascade series, and finally increase speed is given to generator shaft to produce electrical output. Horizontal axis wind turbine on high tower and long blades are very efficient and economic to produce huge amount of electrical output by wind blow. These blades of wind turbine catch wind energy and start spinning. The mechanical rotation produced by wind turbine through gearbox are given to generator rotor, and generator rotor convert mechanical energy into electricity, and double fed induction generator through through their electronic converter produce electrical output which can be synchronized to grid supply conveniently with reliability and stability. The generator output is given to a transformer which step up voltage for grid connectivity and electrical output thus generated run through cable inside the tower of turbine to the base station and through underground cables it can be given to substation for grid connection. All critical function of wind turbine are monitored by suitable sensors at various positions and control center at the bottom of turbine tower and in substation. Automatically control and regulate all instantaneous conditions of turbine operations by SCADA operation. Amount of energy which wind transfer to rotor of generator and produce electrical energy is directly proportional to the kinetic energy of wind flow across rotor sweep area, and it depends upon density of air, the sweep area of rotor blades and the wind speed. And power generated by wind turbine is expressed by this yellow highlight relation, where P is rotor generated mechanical power, rho is density of air, and at 15 degrees Celsius near sea level, air density can be taken as 1.2 kg per meter cube. V is wind speed, and power output is proportional to cubic power of wind velocity. That means if wind velocity get increased by 1%, the power output may increase by 3%. A is sweep area, which is described as circle drawn by rotating blades, and here CP is a power coefficient which represent utilization of wind kinetic energy to produce mechanical power at rotor. And Benz's law states that maximum part of kinetic energy of air which may be theoretically converted into mechanical output from wind turbine cannot be greater than 59.3%. So at best we can convert 59% of total kinetic energy possessed by wind into mechanical rotational energy by a most energy efficient wind turbine action. Typically wind turbine efficiency remain between 35% to 45%. That means we can convert total kinetic energy of wind velocity in rotor blade sweep area only to the extent of 35% to 45%. Use of longer blades on turbine allow more sweeping area of turbine blade rotation, and this allow more wind energy to be converted into electrical output. Higher sweep area of wind turbine can produce higher annual energy production even with low wind speeds, and rotor area increases as square of rotor diameter. So if we double rotor diameter, electrical output will become 4 times. Typically, a utility high power 2 megawatt wind turbine has rotor diameter of 130 meter with rotor blade dimension 64 meter that can make a rotor sweep area of around 13,000 square meters, and that can ultimately produce 2 megawatt electrical output at rated wind velocities of 10 to 15 meter per second. It has now proved that large turbine can deliver electricity output at lower cost than smaller turbine, and reasons are the foundation cost, planning cost are independent of size of turbine, and when we use tall tower heights and long turbine blades we can use low wind speed sites extremely efficiently. And in India, China and USA nowadays all small size wind turbines are being replaced by giant 2 to 3 megawatt size wind turbines having tower height of 120 to 140 meter and rotor sweep diameter around 120 to 130 meters. Theoretically, power generated by wind turbine is directly proportional to cube power of wind speed, and that is also true for low wind speeds. But for all wind speed range, the electric power output of wind turbine generation and wind speed got such a relationship, and at wind speeds less than 3 or 3.5 meter per second, turbine generate no power at all, and the minimum speed above which turbine can produce electrical output is is called cut-in speed, and typically cut-in speed is 3.5 meter per second for utility size wind turbines. Now the maximum efficient electric output will be achieved at wind speed of around 11 or 12 meter per second conditions. Usually wind power plants for such optimum wind speed conditions can be operated only for 10 to 15% of time in a year, as most of the times wind speeds are less than this ideal wind speed conditions, and few times wind speed become extremely high too. In the electric power output and wind speed relation, rated speed is that minimum speed at which wind turbine will generate its designated rated power, and typically for majority of wind turbine machines, rated speed is between 10 to 20 meter per second. For example, this 2 megawatt rating wind turbine will not produce its rated 2 megawatt power if its wind speed is less than rated 11 meter per second speed, and for lower speeds between rated and cutting speed, power output from wind turbine decreases as wind speed decreases or increases as wind speed increases. Output of most wind turbine machines by pitch control is managed to level off at rated capacity, and for very strong wind velocities, which is more than 30 meter per second, the automatic overspeed safety operation will feather the blades in such a way that wind turbine will slow down and ensure safety of all attached mechanical system. At very high speeds above 30 meter per second, most wind turbine cease their power generation and shut down as a safety feature to protect wind turbine from any sort of damage. For that, blade pitch control change orientation of blade, the yaw mechanism change orientation of knuckle bed, and backup mechanical braking mechanism stop turbine generator, and this action is done whenever there is very high wind speed or there exists an electrical fault in grid connectivity. Vestas, General Electric Wind, Siemens, Suzlon, Anarcon, Worldwind, Regan Powertex, and Inox of Adani Group are leading brand in wind turbine manufacturing all over the world and in India. A typical 2 megawatt power utility wind turbine made by Suzlon got these technical specification. Its rated output is 2 megawatt and its generator produces 3-phase alternating current at 50 hertz at 690 volt, and this voltage is step up by internal transformer placed in knuckle to 33 volt for grid connectivity, and transformer rating 2.3 MVA is as per rated output of wind turbine 2 megawatt and operating power factor. Typically cut in and cut out speed for this wind turbine system is 3 meter per second and 20 meter per second. So in between these two speed range, it can produce effectively its electrical output, and between 10 meter per second to 20 meter per second wind velocities, it can produce rated output. This wind turbine have a hybrid lattice tower structure, which at ground position is lattice steel structure, and at top position it is steel tuber structure, and total overall height of this wind turbine tower is 140 meter. Sometimes we can have complete tower of steel tubular design. This 2 megawatt wind turbine have 3 carbon fiber blades of length 63 meter, and during rotation rotor blade diameter will become 129 meter, and total complete sweep area become 13,000 square meter. Thinner and better aerodynamic aerofoil profile of these blades can deliver increased 2 megawatt power when rotor rotate with wind speeds 10 to 20 meter per second. All modern wind turbine generator use slip ring type asynchronous double fed induction generator, and electric output of these generator from stator is directly connected to grid, and in case of imbalance in turbine rotation. When rotor of double fed induction generator is rotating at speed less or higher than synchronous speed, the electronic power converter balance rotor and grid active power flow so that mechanical energy of rotor rotation is most optimally converted into electrical output for grid. These double fed induction generator ensure better reliability and higher stability of grid connectivity during all variable speed operation of wind turbine. We have explained real practical aspect of wind turbine generation in this learning video. Our other video of same playlist and other playlist will enhance your electrical engineering understanding for better professional practices and examination success. We appreciate your interest in viewing and promoting our videos. Thank you very much.